This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to do a couple of examples of horizontal and vertical graph transformations. So I've already done separate videos on horizontal graph transformations and vertical graph transformations. When you have combinations of these, sometimes it can get a bit confusing. And so what I want to do is show you kind of a methodical way of putting it all together. So let's start out with this graph. We'll say that this is a graph of function f. And let's say that we're told to sketch a graph of y equals 2f of x plus 1 plus 2. Okay, so let's take this apart. The f of x plus 1 is telling us the graph is going to move 1 unit to the left. Another way of saying this is each of the x coordinates is going to have 1 subtracted from it. So each of the x coordinates will become x minus 1. We're also going to take the graph and multiply all the y coordinates by 2. That's what this first 2 does. So we want y is going to become 2y, and then we want to add 2 to that. That's what the second 2 does. And then I'm just going to go to each of the points that I have marked and see where they move to. So I've got a point, negative 4, comma 0. The negative 4, which is an x, is going to become negative 4 minus 1, so that would be negative 5. The 0 is going to get multiplied by 2, that's still 0, and we add 2 to it, so that's going to become positive 2. That means I'll have a point at negative 5, comma 2. So here's negative 5 and there's 2. So I've got a point right here. Okay, the next coordinates I have that I have marked are negative 1, comma 1. I want to take that x coordinate, which is negative 1, subtract 1 from it, that becomes negative 2. I want to take the y coordinate, which is positive 1, multiply it by 2, so that will be 2, and add 2, so that will be 4. This means I have a point at negative 2, comma 4. There's negative 2, and there's 4. We can connect those points. I've got another point at 0, comma negative 1. X is 0, y is negative 1. And we want to take that x and subtract 1 from it. So that's 0 minus 1 is negative 1. We want to take the y, which is negative 1, multiply it by 2, so that's negative 2, and then add 2, so that's going to become 0. So I should have a point at negative 1, comma 0. There's negative 1, comma 0. I can connect those. The last point I have is at 4, comma, negative 2. I want to take the x-coordinate, which is 4, and subtract 1, so that's going to become 3. I want to take the y-coordinate, which is negative 2, multiply it by 2, that's negative 4, and then add 2, so it's going to be negative 2, just as it originally was. That means my last point is going to be at 3, comma, negative 2. There's 3, comma, negative 2. Connect the last line. And here's my new graph. It shifted over 1 unit to the left because I had x plus 1 over here. It's been stretched. It's now twice as high vertically as it originally was, and it's also been raised up 2 units, so I get this graph. Okay, let's do one more. Okay, so for this, I'm going to have y equals negative 3 f of negative 2x minus 1. And we use the same approach. We'll find out what's going to happen to the x-coordinates. So the x-coordinates are going to get multiplied by the reciprocal of this negative 2. The reciprocal of negative 2 is negative 1/2. So all of the x-coordinates, whatever those values were, they'll now be negative 1/2 times that value. This is going to have the effect of compressing the graph inward. It will squash it inward horizontally, and it will also flip it across that y-axis. The y-coordinates are going to get stretched by a factor of 3. That's what the 3 does. And also reflected. That's what the negative does. So each y-coordinate will be multiplied by negative 3, and then I want to subtract 1 from it. Okay, so once again, we'll just do this point by point. There's negative 4, comma 0. The negative 4 is going to get multiplied by negative 1/2. That will make it a positive 2. And the 0 is going to get multiplied by negative 3. That's still going to be 0. And then 1 will be subtracted, so it will become negative 1. So I should have a point at 2, comma, negative 1. There's 2, and there's negative 1. My next point is at negative 1, comma, 1. I want to take the x-coordinate, negative 1, and multiply it by negative 1/2. That's going to become positive 1/2. I want to take the y-coordinate, which is 1, multiply it by negative 3, so that's going to be negative 3, minus 1 is negative 4. So I should have a point at 1/2, comma, negative 4. Let's see, 1/2 is about here, and negative 4 would be here. I'll connect those two dots. My next point is at 0, comma, negative 1. So x is 0, y is negative 1. I want to multiply that 0 by negative 1/2. That's still 0. I want to multiply the negative 1, the y-coordinate, by negative 3. So that's positive 3. And then subtract 1 from it. So that's going to become positive 2. So I'll have a point at 0, comma 2. There's 0, and there's 2. Okay, and the last point I've got is 4, comma negative 2. X is 4. Y is negative 2. We'll take that 4 and multiply it by 1/2, by negative 1/2. That's negative 2. We'll take the negative 2, the y-coordinate, multiply that by negative 3. So that's positive 6, and subtract 1 will be positive 5. So I should have a point at negative 2, comma 5. That's here. And I've just got to connect those. Okay, so there's my graph of y equals negative 3f of negative 2x minus 1. Okay, so I hope this idea helped you. Basically, what I find is when you've got too many things to do, it's easy to get confused. So I wanted to show you a kind of methodical way of finding out what happens to each of your original coordinates when they go through the transformation. I hope it helped. Take care. I'll see you next time.